Let's talk today about MIDI, a protocol for transmitting and storing musical performance information. MIDI stands for Musical Instrument Digital Interface, and I want to pay particular attention to that word digital. MIDI has been around for almost 40 years, and one of the reasons for that impressive longevity is the brilliant efficiency in how the designers use digital data to communicate musical performance information. In music, timing is extremely important, and so any communication that we do has to be fast and efficient. So, to appreciate the efficiency of MIDI, let's quickly review bits, bytes, and binary. A bit is a binary unit, a binary digit, and the binary here just means it has two states, on or off, or, as we often represent it, one or zero. Binary matters with computers because it makes it easy to count with electricity. Either there's a voltage on or not, off. This means, though, that computers have to count in a different way than humans normally do. We usually represent 10 different values with one digit, whereas the computer in binary only represents two. With two digits, we usually represent 100 values, and in binary, two digits can only represent four values. Off-off, off-on, on-off, and on-on. As we add more digits, the pattern becomes more clear. In our usual base 10 counting, the number of values we can represent is 10 to the power of the number of digits. So with three digits, we can represent 10 to the power of 3, 1,000. With four digits, 10 to the power of 4, and so on. With binary, it's 2 to the number of digits. So 3 digits is 2 to the third, 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. 4 digits is 2 to the fourth, 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 is 16, etc. So what does this all have to do with music? Well, MIDI information is transmitted digitally, so all of our musical performance information needs to be represented by these ones and zeros. MIDI messages consist of two or three bytes. A byte is a digital word made up of 8 bits. Okay, so from what we know, how many different values can a byte, an 8-digit binary number, represent? 2 to the 8th. So, 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, times 2 is 16, times 2 is 32, times 2 is 64, times 2 is 128, times 2 is 256. Now, in MIDI, there are two kinds of bytes, status bytes and data bytes. Status bytes identify what is going to be done. Is this message about a key going down? Is it about a continuous controller? Data bytes give the values that correspond with those status bytes. Which key is going down? How hard is it going down? Which control knob is being turned? What value is it being turned to? Status bytes always start with a 1, and data bytes always start with a 0. These first binary digits are reserved to let us know what kind of byte we're storing or transmitting. So, since the first bit is reserved, that only leaves us with 7 bits for the rest of our information. How many values is that? 2 to the 7th? So 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, times 2 is 16, times 2 is 32, times 2 is 64, times 2 is 128. So 0 to 127. If you've done any work in MIDI before, these numbers might be familiar. 0 to 127 is the range of MIDI pitches, the range of MIDI velocities, the range of continuous controller information, and even the number of general MIDI program instruments, though they're numbered 1 to 128. Next video, we'll get more into the different kinds of MIDI messages, but understanding why our range of values is from 0 to 127 is useful. It's because we can store that range of values in a single byte. When we think about files, and that a megabyte is over 1 million bytes, we can start to really consider the scale of how efficient this is. Efficiency, though, is not just about speed. MIDI is efficient because it's fast and effective. 128 is not a great number of values, but do we need more than 128 pitches? More than 128 different key velocities? Arguably, this MIDI information is particularly effective for certain kinds of music, but not all. And next time we'll get into the different types of MIDI messages, and we can think more about if we're satisfied with these messages covering the range of musical expression that we want.